Shri Ganata Singh.
Many of you may go to a concert, sit there and wonder what is going on. What are these artists on stage doing? What are the languages they are singing on? What are they singing on? What is this thing they put there on their hand? Or what is the thing they keep beat on their hand? People call it talam. People next to you scare you even more by using complicated words, names of ragas, names of talas, and terms that seriously don't make any sense when you first hear it. Everybody will say, Yenna Shruti la parre, or what Shruti are you singing at? Or Shruti Serarda, is the Shruti in tune? Or are you in tune with the Shruti? These are terms that everybody would come across. So the basic question is, what is this Shruti?
I believe in simple terms, it's scale or pitch or octave. Or
well, scale and pitch are two different things. They're not necessarily the same thing. So everybody's voice, first of all, has its own range, could we say, or tone. Similarly, instruments also have their range and tone. In Indian classical music, whether it is Hindustani music or Carnatic music, we fix this pitch, this tone, so that all the music is played according to that fixed pitch. And the swaras in the Indian classical system, both Hindustani, is sa, ri, ga, ma, pa, da, ni. If I was just going to just sing it, sa ri ga ma pa da ni sa sa ni da pa ma ga ri sa sa ri ga ma pa da ni are the seven swaras that are there. I sang it in an ascending fashion and a descending fashion. That's all I did. There are two things you must understand here. Is that one, when I used the word pitch or shruti just a few minutes ago, the note that determines that pitch is the note, two notes actually, but the primary note is sa. This is the note that determines my pitch. Suppose my pitch was, say, instead of sa, it was then that would become my sa, sa. If it was her, her pitch would be higher. Sa, it would be somewhere else. So the sa is the note that determines the pitch. A supplementary note that helps you is the swara pa. So sa, pa, these two notes. These two notes are fixed and cannot be changed, immovable. Okay, and on stage, in a concert, this note is constantly reminded to you by what is known as a tambura. And that's what I have behind me here. So the four strings she has here plays two notes, pa and sa. Okay, now I'll just ask her to play this once. So this is the role of the tambura that you see on stage in a concert. The role of the tambura is to constantly remind the musician of the pitch on which they are singing. Now, before I go anywhere, I think it's important for me to clarify what is it to sing in Shruti. You say, okay, you have to sing in Shruti. But how do I know if somebody is not singing in Shruti? Very good question. It's a very difficult thing for me to do, is to sing out of Shruti, which I'm going to try now. Now, I told you that this tambura here fixes. I have said that my voice is like this, my range is so much, so this is my Shruti. What I have in front of me, for just to clarify, is a recorded version of the same tambura that I have behind. Okay? So now, sa sa ri ga ma sa. I want him to play just sa constantly. Was this okay? Was this okay? Did anybody think it sounded very nice? Now I'll ask him to play sa again. I promise you, this is not how I sing when I sing my concerts. This is singing out of Shruti. So the constant reference for me is the sa and pa, which is provided by the tambura. Some of the basic aspects of music. Shruti, tala, gamaka, raga, different types of ragas, different types of talas. Let's actually go to the music as a whole.
Padumana parama purusha paranjoti swarupa vidura vandya vimala charita vihangadi rohana udadi nivasa uragashayana unnatonata mahima yadukurottama yajnarakshaka ajna sikshaka ramana.
So, as you can see, these songs are quite simple, not very complicated. And these are the first compositions that we learn.